Magandang araw sa inyong lahat. Introduction to Accounting and Financial Information. Yan po ang ating topic ngayon. Ito po ang kauna-unahang topic sa PAPM 2. Ito dapat yung malaman, lalo na ng mga senior high school at yung pang EBM students. Ano ba ang objectives nito? Ang mga layunin nito ay ang mga sumusunod. At the end of this video, the learner should be able to define accounting, discuss the qualitative characteristics of useful financial information, and discuss how useful financial information affects business decisions. Yan po ang inyong mga malalaman. Definition of accounting. It can be compared to specialized language with the purpose of sending an accurate message to users of accounting information. Special language po ito na dapat natin ginagamit sa ating business. Kaya nga, in short, it is the language of business. But let me give you the conventional yet complete definition of accounting, which goes this way. Accounting is the process of identifying, measuring, recording, and communicating economic information about an economic organization or entity in order to permit informed judgment by the users of financial information. Sa definition pong ito ay kitang-kita yung accounting process na ginagawa natin sa ating mga business. Using the economic information, yung business transaction po yun. At ito po'y kinakailangan para makapag-desisyon ang users of financial statements or information, which is both internal users and external users. So mahalaga po na matutunan accounting hindi lang ng mga accountants, maging ng may-ari ng negosyo. Definition of accounting presented and explained graphically. Kung mapapansin nyo po dito, we have business transactions. Ito po yung input natin. Ito po yung araw-araw na nangyayari sa isang business araw-araw. Depende sa kanyang operating cycle. Then we have to identify the business transactions. Papasok po siya dito sa process. Then we have to measure using the Philippine peso, measurable po kasi, involving the amount of money for the goods or services acquired or sold out. Yan po. Then we have to record, recording na po. Yung pong tatlo, identification, measurement, and recording, yun yung pong process ng accounting major process. Then, ilalabas na po natin siya para maging output. Ito po yung communicating useful information, financial in nature, sa internal and external users. On short, input, yun po yung business transactions, then process, tatlo po, identification, measurement, recording, then we have the final output, communicating useful financial information sa internal users. Then we have the financial information. Ano po bang meaning nito? Pag sinabing financial information, it is the story that accounting tells to users, which are communicated through financial statements. Ito po isang story, which are economic story using economic entity, that is the business organization. Okay, ano ga po yung mga financial statements na yun? Unang-una po yung statement of financial position. Ito po yung tinatawag na balance sheet dun sa PAPM 1 natin. Then it contains assets, liabilities, and equity, which is reported for a point in time labeled as of, as at. So kung mapapansin nyo po dito sa SFP natin, statement of financial position, ito po ay makikita natin yung concept of basic accounting equation, which is asset equals liabilities plus capital. Next financial statement, yung pong statement of comprehensive income. It contains revenues or income and expenses, which is reported for a period in time labeled for the period ended. Makikita po ito sa heading. Kasama po ito sa pangalan lang ni business. Yun po yung statement of comprehensive income. Ang elements niya po ay income or revenue and expenses. After deduction of expenses, lalabas po yung net income. Then we have the next financial statement, statement of changes in equity. It contains transactions involving owner's equity, which is reported for a period in time, labeled also for the period ended. So pag sinabing for the period ended, end of month ito, kung halimbawa isang taon, for the period ended December 31 of the current year or the concerned year. Then we have the statement of cash flows. It contains transactions involving cash which is reported for a period in time labeled for the period ended. Yan po. A statement of cash flows po naman, it involves the operating, financing, and investing activities of the organization. Meron po tayo mga videos dyan na papapanood nyo rin po dito sa profile ko po. Then we have explanatory notes. Ito naman po, hindi financial statement, pero ito ay explanatory notes to support the financial statement. It contains other information with no specific period or point in time labels. Narrative report po kasi ito. Kung saan makikita natin yung mga changes o mga nangyari na hindi maintindihan masyado ng users ng financial statements para po mas malinaw. Then we have the qualitative characteristics of financial information. Ano po ba yung characteristics ng financial information? Unang-una po dito yung relevance. Dapat po may kaugnayan yung financial information po. Ano? Some stories kasi are true but not appropriate for conversation. May mga story tayo na hindi naman kailangan sa ating financial information, so hindi natin siya sasama. The same goes with accounting, where some information are true but not significant for users' decision making process. The information is said to be relevant if it can predict a situation or scenario that is useful for decision making. Okay? Another qualitative characteristic is faithful presentation. Sa Tagalog po, ito yung makatotohanang pagpapahayag ng financial information. It has been said that there is a big difference between a story and a gossip. Ano po? Storyteller and a gossiper. Magkaiba po yun. Yung isa po ay makatotohanan, yung isa po ay makapanira. Accounting is always concerned about the true story rather than a gossip or a hearsay. Yung po yung pitfall presentation. Then we have comparability. The financial information can be compared to similar business organizations. Ano? Then it is similar to expression apples to apples comparison. An entity's information is said to be comparable if the information can be compared to another entity. Okay, yun pong makatotohanan yun. Ano? Then we have the next qualitative characteristic is verifiability. It can be verified. It means that the transparency users can reach an agreement about the financial information. Verifiability or verifiable, okay? It can be verified. Then we have timeliness. Remember that people make decisions based on what they know at hand. Ibig sabihin po, timeliness, dapat po ito ay walang delay. Pag sinabing period in time or as of, dapat po ang financial information ay timely po at hindi po siya delayed. Kasi kung hindi siya timely, ang ating pong decision making process ay maantala. Yun po yung timeliness. Then last is understandability. In business dealings, the information must be clear, malinaw, brief, short, and concise. Okay? In order to be understandable by the users. Dapat po hindi siya jargon na ang nakakaintindi lang ay yung accountant. Dapat po yung users, both internal and external, ay naintindihan yung financial information. Okay? Qualitative characteristic, ulitin natin, relevance, faithful presentation, comparability, verifiability, timeliness, and understandability of financial information. Yun po yung qualitative characteristics niya. Paano nga ba ang financial information affect business decision? How does financial information affects business decisions? The role of an accountant in any business organization is like a game scorer, okay? The scorer records every point earned by its team in the game. Then, the scores will be tallied at the end of the game, which will be determined whose team did well or not. The same is true with accountants who keep track of business performance. To be useful in decision making process, to saan po gagamitin? Whether to invest additional capital or never. Magdadagdag pa ba ng buhunan o hindi na? Whether to sell the investment or not. Ibibenta na ba yung ating negosyo sa iba o hindi na? Okay? Whether to shut down operation or expand. Magsasara na ba tayo or palawakin pa ang ating operations or mag-branch out? Whether to enter or extend the loans. Tayo po ba ay mangungutang pa ng loans o magpapautang pa tayo ng loans sa mga debtors? Then, other relevant business decisions needed. So, ito po yung mga pakinabang sa financial information at marami pa pong iba na dapat natin isaalang-alang upang ating financial information ay magamit natin ng wasto sa ating decision-making process. Thank you for watching. Please click the follow button or the follow button for more videos po. God bless. Sana po natuto kayo at huwag niyo kalimutang i-follow.